my studio. This is the nancynicoleart.com web store, and this is my studio. It's I do all the paintings right here at this table. I have another area where I frame, and if you have been to my store, you know that one of the things I love to do and do a lot of is oyster shells. In fact, the collection is called Just Oysters. And so I do all variety of sizes. The one against the wall is a 3 feet by 4 feet. I've had many requests for that size. I do another size, the panel that's up there, this celadon green background. That's a very nice size because it fits over a table or over a twin bed. It's a really great size. And I'm in the middle of doing oyster shells right now because we have the Oyster Fest coming October 14th and 15th. And at my gallery, it's actually a partnership gallery called Off Main Gallery in Wellfleet, we'll be doing demonstrations and having a variety of oyster products, including paintings, for sale. So hopefully if you're reading this or seeing this, you will come by. And you can also always order on this online store, nancynicoleart.com. So how I start with an oyster painting, I have these panels. You can buy them. Sometimes I have my friend Brian make them for me. I like the hard surface because you can scratch into it if you want to. And this is a small one, so we'll just do a single. I'll show you how I start. Sometimes I do two paintings at the same time. Don't tell anybody. But I line them up, and I like to have some of the shadow because it actually gives you an indication of the shape of the shell, which I love these shells. Chip, who's a local oyster man, brings me all kinds. For instance, there's one that has a heart. You can make out the heart on that one. And there's another one here that has the beginning of a pearl. You can see that little bump that's forming. So he likes to get these back, the ones with the pearl, even though it's just a little stubby thing. And I use oil bars. This is great oil paint in bar form. R&F paint is the place I'd like to get them. You can get them other places, of course. And I just start with just feeling the shape and marking it out on the, have too many details yet. Get the basic shape in. So this will be a single, and because there's a lot of white, I sometimes just go for it and fill in the white. I forgot to put white paint out. White and gray are like so important when you're working on oysters. And also having cans for turpentine. I have to eat canned food now because I always need a can for turps. This particular shell has white all through here, and a little white on the edge will be like that. And I sometimes just mark out where the purple, I call the medallions, I don't know what the technical name is for that purple. It's not always purple either, sometimes it's dark red or black, that shape there. And yellow ochre is a really good color to use because there are some yellows in your oyster, and also the outside edge. Sometimes I block that in right away, get that going. As I say, you can order various sizes. So here's and some other colors to use. The grays are really great. Get going here with some different. So you don't have to apply the oil bar directly to the surface. You can squeeze the paint out. And then the other thing is you always have a consistent color. So if you go back over and you want some gray, you get the same color without having to worry about mixing it up. So this is when you're quick, when you're doing quick paintings, as I said, for a fest or for an event, one way to work is using the oil bars because they're quick. I guess we'll give this guy, we'll start out with some red in the center there and some dark up there. One of the trickiest places is that little part at the top. And the next thing I do almost always, and I think I put light colored paint out here because the shadow is so important Instead, we're using the same brush over and over. I don't always do that, but for the sake of this video, I'd like to outline and give definition to the shape where this is going, because as I say, we want to utilize the shadow to tell us more about the oyster shell itself. And there's a lot of little tiny cracks and little details that make oyster shells the most fascinating things to paint. So once I have a little idea of where my shading might go, I'm going to decide, okay, what color is the background? The background's very critical, and I think we'll use one of my favorites, cerulean blue. I'm using this, you can use them right down to the nub, where at that point I would start to fill in the background. It's a nice juicy paint. You can see how, I mean, if you're watching this, you know how much fun this is to just squeeze the paint out. It's like working with butter. I just love to do that. I don't care. I've been working with paint all my life so far, and I'm still alive. I get paint all over myself. I don't know. People say it's toxic, but it makes me happy. So far, no problem. So I just, you know, want to show you how I get started. I don't have time to do this whole thing. A little single shell. And I need a bullet. See. Then the next thing, just cover it over. You can always go back and brighten it with some fresh paint if it gets mixed in. I hope that if you're watching this, you're planning to come to the Oyster Fest. It's a lot of fun. There are a lot of different vendors, a lot of great art, a lot of music, rock and roll. If you like rock and roll. Excellent food. And it's a highlight, of course, with the oysters. It's a big draw every year. So we need to have a little shading. I guess we'll put some of that right there. Emphasize the outside edge, maybe some there. I use, I guess I don't even have it here, odorless turpentine. I use a lot of liquin, and I need this linseed oil to clean up my oil bars from time to time. Maybe we're going to have time to do this whole thing. That'll be fun. To give credit to my photographer here, which is my good friend Martha Delamar, get your name right, who was graciously offered to be my photojournalist today. A little blue down in there. It's usually a little swirl that goes down into that, and we probably want that to be a little darker. I don't know what that little thing is called. I meant to look it up today and see if it has a special name, but for right now, we'll call it the medallion. So that's how these start. And if you order them online, you know, the turnaround time for, because the oil paint has to dry, I would say 2 weeks tops. You could order for a holiday. I've had orders for a wedding party where I did 6 oysters were going to be the gifts, and that was very successful because I could match the bridesmaids, the color of their gowns to the background of the painting, and so they're very kind of compatible and kind of a lovely remembrance. A little darker there, a little dark on the outside edge, maybe one of those. You don't need a huge studio to accomplish a beautiful painting. That's what I've learned over the years. I've had big studios, and now, where I live here in Wellfleet, this is very adequate. I paint, this morning I was up at 5 o'clock. I paint, I love to paint. I get up the crack of dawn and work on a painting. And I also go to bed early then, exhausted sometimes. And if you Over on the table, there's a number of paintings that are finished that will go to the Oyster Fest. And I can show you what the finished product looks like. It's cerulean blue, and then the five that are lined up are all primed and ready to go. And sometimes I do triples with the three shells, and other times I just like the simplicity of two shells that are kind of talking to each other, like a relationship. I think there's quite a bit of magic to oyster shells. Everyone tells a different story. So I want to thank you for coming to this, my first video on my web store, and I hope to continue this process. The next one, I'm going to be working on a collage. Was invited to a show in New York that all about collaging. So I will be doing one, a map of Paris. So stay tuned, and maybe in a week or so, come back and see if there's another posting. Thanks, Martha, for being the film crew.